answer. And the conversation that we have had, I believe that you would advocate a lot of people to get into freelancing, correct?
Yeah.
Would you say freelancing is a very good profession right in the beginning, or maybe if you've had certain experience in a corporate, then you should look forward to be a freelancer?
I would say that a person needs to spend at least 5 years in the industry,
okay,
before starting on his own.
Yeah. Right.
A minimum of 5 years has to be there to learn the tricks of the trade.
And so if using 5 years is one where you work and then you become a freelancer,
yeah,
right? Okay. And some strategy, let's say you get into this business, you start getting business, but this is a very competitive area also. So are there any strategies that a freelancer need to have to survive in this competitive market?
They should associate with somebody, because that will help. Because some group is already getting work.
Correct.
If they associate with them,
right,
they will be saving a lot of time.
You mentioned that it is always good not to be completely independent, but maybe form a pool.
Yeah.
And that would give a lot of weightage to your company or your services.
Yeah, yeah. It also saves you from isolation.
Correct.
And plus, like, if you are part of a team, then somebody else can check your work,
okay,
or give you some feedback.
Right.
So
right,
the
right,
feedback will
right,
come from mm-hmm, your colleagues.
Excellent.
And not from the client. So the things that a client would have caught, your colleagues will catch it beforehand. Because in copy editing, a fresh pair of eyes is always better. Because you get so involved in your own work,
right,
that even an obvious mistake you will not
right,
see.
What is one thing which a KP or a publisher sees as the biggest advantage of hiring a freelancer?
Because the industry is very competitive, like the rates that they are getting from their clients are getting lower and lower. So they can save a lot of money,
okay,
by hiring freelancers, because otherwise they need to invest in training, and it's a long process. It's not that you can train somebody to become a copy editing freelancer in a week. So it's a long process, and we were fortunate that when we started, there was not so much of work. So we had enough time for training, and we had somebody who was like passionate enough to train us.
Correct.
But today the situation is drastically different. It's like things need to be done at a fast pace.
Correct. Correct.
The turnaround times are getting shorter.
Correct.
Because before things come in print, they might appear online.
Right. Right.
So publishers want things to be done fast. So to take care of that, publishers need to have a pool of freelance.
So yeah, I mean, I get what you're saying. That's one big advantage a publisher would have by looking at freelancers. My final question to you, we talked about probably only books. How is the freelancing scene when it comes to journals?
In books, like, there will be a cycle. Like, some months there will be less work,
okay,
and some months there will be more work, because the publishing dates of books need to coincide with the universities or the colleges.
Okay.
Because a lot of content is getting generated there.
Right.
But journals, it's like a year-round activity. So if you are doing journals, you can be sure of a particular minimum number of pages.
And but are the skills different at the journals and at the books?
I would say a book copy editor can easily do journal copy editing.
Okay.
But not the other way around.
Oh.
Because a journal article is not very big.
Okay.
So your attention span has to be shorter. But a book can run into thousands of pages.
Okay, okay.
Like, it can be even 10,000 pages.
Any guess as to, let's say, if there are 5,000 freelancers in this country, how many would be focusing only on journals?
I would say more than 75% are probably doing journals.
Is it?
Yeah.
Oh, why? Because it's short and gives you quick money.
Yeah. And the skill sets required for book copy editing, it's like you need more experience. So maybe KPOs do it in-house.
Mm.
It's like better to control. It's more manageable.
Mm.
Giving out a 10,000 page book,
mm.
a single freelancer will not be able to handle. Then you need to give out to a team.
Mm.
And different people will be doing. There can be consistency issues.
No, I think now we are going a little different. So are you saying most of the jobs that come to freelancers are for journals?
Yeah.
Not for books?
From the client side,
huh.
the books job are also coming to the KPOs.
Mm.
But KPOs prefer
mm.
to give out journals okay. rather than books.
Okay. Good, Vivek. It's been a nice chat. And I'm very sure that many, many...